Welcome to Qt Widgets and More. In the previous episode, we saw a view communicate to a model at the bottom of a large proxy model stack. It needed to ask that model something specific for each cell in the view. In this episode, I will look at a slightly different way of doing that. Now my view needs to talk to the model at the bottom, but it's independent of the items in the stack. Let's look at the user interface from the previous episode. I had the possibility of right-clicking on a cell, and there was this Jesper Pedersen that we could see. However, there's also an export to PDF option in here. If I choose that, you can see I got a PDF version of my table. The export to PDF is not specific for this particular dashlet in KDAB viewer. No, it's there for every single dashlet that uses my KDAB table view. So here's the problem. In my PDF export, I would like to have a title at the top of the page above the table that I'm printing. How would I get that title? Well, it's only the model at the bottom of the proxy model stack that knows that. I can, of course, make that model subclass from some interface that has a page title method that I could call. But how do I get to that model? It might be below several proxy models, as we saw in the previous video. Let's investigate the code to see how this works. KDAB table view, that's a table class that I use in numerous different places. Context menu event, that's what brings up the context menu. And you can see here, menu add action, new export to PDF action. So I created a class export to PDF action, which is the actual exporting code and has all the logic for finding the title and so on built into it. Let's see what it does. Export to PDF action, as I said, a subclass of Q action. And let's just scroll up here at the constructor. Just finding the constructor. There we are. Export to PDF, that's a Q action that I set up here. Whenever it's triggered, call export to PDF. Okay, that's the code that we need to investigate then. Export to PDF uses KD report. And in case you don't know what KD report is, it's a report generator for generating PDF files. Right there, there is a link in case you want to learn more about KD reports. KD report set up this is just general KD report code. That's not the interesting part. The interesting part comes down here. If I have an interface, then create a text element with the export title of that interface. And let me just find that interface. Well, let me just find this one here. This is the interface class. This is the model at the bottom of my stack. Can subclass from this interface class to be able to specify the export title here. It also has a number of other methods that it can override. Okay, but my KDAB table view, I use that in at least 50, if not 100 different places. And I don't want to bother implementing this interface for every single model. So it has the possibility of not being implemented. And if it isn't implemented, I simply will not get this title up here. But if it's implemented, and that's what we'll be looking at now, if it's implemented, I'll call that method. So how do I find that particular class? I do that with this search for interface method. It's straight down here. I have a loop that runs forever. Let's hope it doesn't get that long because that's too long for me, but forever. I start asking the view for its model, and I assign that to the instance variable here, or to the local variable called model. If I don't have a model the first time I get in here, then I'll just return null pointer, I didn't find one. Actually, it's much worse if I don't have a model at all, but that's beside the point right now. Okay, let's try to dynamic cast this model to an export to PDF interface. If that succeeds, then I found an interface and I'll return that. Otherwise, let me try and cast my model here to a QAbstract proxy model. So I see if the model that I currently have my fingers on, if it's actually a QAbstract proxy model, because if it is, then I can go and ask for a source model to go to the model that it is asking for its data. If that's the case, I will assign that, and I'm one step down my proxy model stack, and I'll continue until I either end up with no source model, so proxy models all the way, or I'm getting to a model that is not a subclass of export to PDF interface. And then I'll just return null pointer. And if I find it, I will return that interface. That's basically the key point of this episode here. So instead of going through the proxy model stack via an index, I will simply go and look at each of the proxy models and check whether they are a subclass of this export to PDF interface. And if they are, I found it. Otherwise, I'll just carry on without it. Let's, however, see one more feature that is in here, because I also want to be able to allow filtering out based on this interface. The filtering out comes from this cleanup report proxy model. So the cleanup report proxy model, I create an instance of that with the header view or the horizontal header view and this interface that I found, if I found it. And it looks like this. It's a Qsort filter proxy model. Let's just go down here. I create that proxy. I give it my input model as the source for that one. And then I add that to my table. And my table will then go and query the proxy model for all the data as it prints it out into PDF. The cleanup report proxy model class looks like this. Remembering some stuff here. And then filter accept, let's just do this one first. That's the easy one. Filter accept column. I will only include the columns if the section in the view isn't hidden. So I can hide my columns from the view using facility, and I'll show that in a later episode too. But if a column has been hidden, it will not be printed in the PDF either. So those that are not hidden will be included. The filter accept row will test whether a given row should be included. And it tests so using the interface. So first of all, if I don't have an interface, then I will not filter it out. So I'll just include everything. But if I have, I will go and ask the interface, should I include this particular row? And the row, I need to map the index. Proxy models. That's one thing that you need to learn about proxy models. You are not allowed to give an index to any other model than the one that created the index itself. So I need to take my index. I see an index from the top of my model stack. I need to take that index and convert it into an index of the interface down here. Actually, I'm just going for the number, for the row number, but some of my proxy models could actually throw away some of the rows. So therefore I need to map that. So that's what my map to bottom model row does. It goes like this. I start out looking at my source model. I assert that source model actually exists. And I know that all of those things that I assert on in this function here, I know that they're okay, because if they weren't, I wouldn't have gotten my hand onto an interface pointer to start with. Okay, I take this interface, I convert it into a QAbstract item model, and that's the one at the bottom that I'm looking for. Okay, I take my index and I create an index from row, whatever row I'm at, comma zero, that's column zero. Now I have a Q model index for that. As long as I'm not down at the bottom of my stack, I will take my proxy model here. I will cast it to a QAbstract proxy model, because I know that I have only QAbstract proxy models between the view at the top and the model that the interface is relating to at the bottom. I assert that I have that. Then I'll take the source model and make that to my model, and I'll index, I'll map the current proxy, map that index that I have there to an index of the source model. So this way I will traverse my way all the way down into the bottommost model, and there I will ask for its row. I could, of course, have done what I did in the previous video and just have a special enum that represent, or a special int is really what it boils down to, the role of what row are you. And then I could just ask my topmost model to map the about that information. And then while it maps its way down into the bottom, the row would be updated. And then at the bottom, I would simply just return index.row. Two different ways of doing the same thing. Again, the reason why I chose this implementation with the map to bottom row and the searching through the hierarchy until I found the interface is simply that I do not want to complex my data method with the information about something that isn't really about the data. You've been watching Qt Widgets and More. I'm Jesper Pedersen. Thank you for your attention. And do remember, subscribe to our channel. Give me a thumbs up. Do call us if there's anything we can help you with, and so on. Until next time, have a great day.